Good morning, and welcome to Immaculate Heart of Mary. Today we celebrate the Ascension of the Lord. The readings for today's Mass can be found in your red worship book, number 1094. That's 1094 in your red worship book. Please join in singing from your red worship book, number 524, Hail Thee Festival Day. That's 524 in your red worship book. Please rise. We will be singing the Ascension refrain and verses 1, 2, and 4. Festival day, blessed day to be hallowed forever, day when our Lord ascends high in the heavens to reign. He who was nailed to the cross is ruler and Lord of all people. Created on earth, sing to the glory of God. Hail thee, festival day, blessed day to be hallowed forever, day when our Lord ascends high in the heavens to reign. Your face, Jesus Christ, that we may rejoice in your brightness. Give us the light of your day, darkened on earth at your death. Hail the festival day, blessed day to be hallowed forever, day when our Lord ascends high in the heavens to reign. Jesus, the health of the world and light in our minds, great Redeemer, Son of the Father supreme, only begotten of God. Hail thee, festival day, blessed day to be hallowed forever, day when our Lord ascends high in the heavens to reign.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear friends in Christ, today we commemorate the ascension of our Lord Jesus Christ into heaven. It's a sign of hope for all of us that when our days are done here on earth, we also will join our Lord Jesus Christ in the company of all the saints. May this be our portion through Christ our Lord. I am Father James Adeoye. I'm from Nigeria. My diocese is the Lorne Diocese. I'm here to join you in this assembly at this Eucharistic Mass to preach the mission appeal for this year for my diocese. So we are grateful for the Archbishop Brennan, for Father John, for all of you for having us come around. So as we celebrate together the sign of our unity, the sign of the Father, we are all part of the body of Christ during this Mass, I present your prayers to the Lord. I present your family. I present your pains, your joy, your happiness. I present everything before the altar of the Lord. And may the good Lord hear and answer our prayers through the same Christ, our Lord. Let us now humble ourselves before our God by acknowledging our faults and asking the Lord for pardon and for mercy as we prepare for the worthy celebration of these sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen, amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill.
Let us pray. Gladden us with holy joy, Almighty God, and make us rejoice with devout thanksgiving for the ascension of Christ, your Son, is our exhortation. And where the head has gone before in glory, the body is called to follow in hope. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In the first book, Theophilus, I dealt with all that Jesus did and taught until the day he was taken up, after giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles whom he had chosen. He presented himself alive to them by many proofs after he had suffered, appearing to them during 40 days and speaking about the kingdom of God. While meeting with them, he enjoined them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father about which you have heard me speak. For John baptized with water, but in a few days you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit. When they had gathered together, they asked him, Lord, are you at this time going to restore the kingdom to Israel? He answered them, It is not for you to know the times or the seasons that the Father has established by his own authority. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, throughout Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. When he had said this, as they were looking on, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him from their sight. While they were looking intently at the sky as he was going, suddenly two men dressed in white garments stood beside them. They said, Men of Galilee, why are you standing there looking at the sky? This Jesus who has been taken up from you into heaven will return in the same way as you have seen him going into heaven. The word of the Lord.
The psalm can be found in your Blue Gather book, number 51, God Mounts His Throne. That's 5-1 in your Blue Gather book.
God mounts his throne to shouts of joy. Oh, sing your praises to the Lord. God mounts his throne to shouts of joy. Oh, sing your praises to the Lord. All you peoples, clap your hands, shout to God in gladness. The Lord we must fear, King of all the earth. God mounts his throne to shouts of joy. Oh, sing your praises to the Lord. God goes up to shouts of joy. Sound the trumpet blast. Sing praise to our God. Praise unto our King. God mounts his throne to shouts of joy. Oh, sing your praises to the Lord. God is King of all the earth. Sing with all your skill to the King of all nations. God enthroned on high. God mounts his throne to shouts of joy. Oh, sing your praises to the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, may the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation resulting in knowledge of him. May the eyes of your hearts be enlightened, that you may know what is the hope that belongs to his call, what are the riches of glory in his inheritance among the holy ones, and what is the surpassing greatness of his power for us who believe, in accord with the exercise of his great might, which he worked in Christ, raising him from the dead and seating him at his right hand in the heavens, far above every principality, authority, power, and dominion, and every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the one to come. And he put all things beneath his feet and gave him his head over all things to the church, which is his body, the fullness of the one who fills all things in every way. The word of the Lord.
All nations, says the Lord, I am with you always until the end of the world. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus said to his disciples, go into the whole world and proclaim the gospel to every creature. Whoever believes and is baptized will be saved. Whoever does not believe will be condemned. These signs will accompany those who believe. In my name, they will drive out demons. They will speak new languages. They will pick up serpents with their hands. And if they drink any deadly thing, it will not harm them. They will lay hands on the sick, and they will recover. So then the Lord Jesus, after he spoke to them, was taken up into heaven and took his seat at the right hand of God. But they went forth and preached everywhere while the Lord worked with them and confirmed the word through accompanying signs. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear people of God, it is good to know that today, since last year, we are free to attend Mass without compulsorily or necessarily having to cover up, you know, with mask. That sounds so good, right? Yeah. Oh, let's clap. We need to clap. Let's clap. Let's celebrate that. That's wonderful. You know, it's an achievement. It's a sign of light at the end of the tunnel. And we also just sang, and we are still singing, and we will still sing even at this Mass, you know, for the first time, I think, because when you cover up, you don't have to sing. You rely on the, you know, proficiency of our choir director, you know, and the singer, you know, to help us out. But we can join them today, which is something wonderful. I know St. Cecilia and the company of all the saints in heaven will be smiling and be happy with all of a whole. They are singing again. The church is alive. It's wonderful. May the name of the Lord be praised, both now and forevermore. And the pandemic is not over yet. And so we join our prayers with those parts of the world, especially India, that are still struggling so much to figure out how they will cope, you know, with the spread and the scourge of this pandemic. We pray at this Mass that God will help us, because this is a global, pandemic. It affects everyone. So we pray that God will come to our assistance so that in no distant time, this will be behind us. I pray through Christ our Lord. Amen. Now, today is the Ascension Day. So I will talk to you about two things. I will reflect on the reality of Ascension and the command to go out and proclaim the good news. Then I will conclude with the mission appeal for my diocese in Ilorin. So the Ascension of the Lord. Of course, I know that we all have an idea. We know what the Ascension means, that after the sojourn of Jesus on earth, he was taken up to heaven. We just read that, you know, in the gospel. But why did Jesus come? You know, why? He came because God loves us. John 3:16, you know, everybody knows that. While I was even in elementary school, I was, you know, we're told, you know, to cram that. John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whoever believes in him will be saved. And the gospel tells us something about that today, that when you believe in him, you will not be condemned. And he showed us the way of God, the life of God, that the life of God is the life of love, is the life of forgiveness, the life of compassion, the life of joy and happiness. He showed us who God is in a very special way. We can touch God through Jesus. We can hear God through the voice of Jesus. We can feel the compassion of God through the life of Jesus. Jesus wept. Jesus wept. You know, people will say that the shortest verse in the Bible at the tomb of Lazarus. He showed pity to people. Oh, he attended to them because they were like sheep without shepherd. He had pity, compassion on them. And we felt the love, the compassion, the joy, the forgiveness of God through the ministry of Jesus Christ. And so while he was being taken up to heaven, he told the disciples in a very special way, my job is not complete. You need to go out and proclaim the good news. The compassion must continue. The love must continue. The forgiveness must continue. The kindness must go on. Through who? Through you. All of us, especially those of us that have been baptized. You know, on the day of your baptism, you were anointed first with the whole of catechumen to take away the scourge, the stain, the indelible mark of, you know, original sin from you. Then secondly, we all were anointed with the whole of chrism. The power of chrism gives us the grace, the power to share in the threefold ministry of our Lord Jesus Christ as king, as prophet, and as what? And as priest. So we have this same evangelical mandate to go out to proclaim the good news of our Lord Jesus. Saint Pope John Paul II, in one of his encyclicals, Redemptoris Missio, actually assured all of us that nothing must make us to shift our gaze away from this mandate to proclaim the good news of our Lord Jesus Christ. And every epoch, every period, every era in the history of humanity has major needs. Can we itemize the needs of our own time? Especially with this pandemic, a lot of people are just like on the edge coming out of the lockdown. A lot of people, they have developed different coping mechanisms. A lot of people, they have suffered loneliness. A lot of people, they have been like, I'm working from home remotely. For how long will this continue? To continue to gaze on the computer, that can be tiring sometimes. And we are coming out of all of this. What does the world need now? More compassion, more love, the ability to listen more to one another, the ability to consider the opinions of others from their own point of view, the ability to look at your neighbor, your wife, your husband in the face and say, I am here for you. And Jesus is sending you out to bring compassion to the world, more love to the world, more kindness to the world, to your neighbor. And as Jesus is sending you out, he's also reminding all of us that we must become sanctified, sanctifier, evangelized, evangelizer, and redeemer. And what that means is that before you can show love, compassion to people, you must love yourself, learn to show yourself compassion, learn to be gentle with yourself, learn to appreciate yourself, learn to go into yourself and deep down to find out how uniquely made you are. I usually remind people and say, you are so great. You are unique from birth to the extent that nobody, there is no other copy of you on the surface of the earth. What's your name, my brother?
Matt.
Go to Germany, go to France, go to Africa, go to everywhere. There is no other person like you. I can only say I saw somebody, you know, in California that resembles you, but not exactly like you. You are you. Just only copy of you on the surface of the earth. You are great. God has made from young, even while we were still in the womb, he told us that. He said, look, before you were born, I knew you. I've consecrated you. All of us are specially made. And so when you begin to entertain things like depression, things like negative thoughts and everything, know that you are more than that. Right from the day of your birth. So when you take care of yourself, you show compassion and love to yourself, it will not be difficult for you to extend it to others, to the members of your family. So Jesus is sending all of us out, sending us out, each and every one of us, to become disciples of compassion, disciples of love, disciples of care, disciples of the gospel, the message of eternal life in the world today. I, the Lord of sea and land, I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in dark and sing, my hand will save. Here I am, Lord, it is I, Lord, I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart. I'm here again to speak to you about how we can hold people in the Lonely Diocese in your heart. And today, I want to talk to you about how my diocese in the Lonely is responding to the humanitarian challenge that came up because of the insecurity in Nigeria. It is not a new thing, though it is like increasing in the past month now because of the attack from some herdsmen and hoodlums. They claim they are not from Nigeria, but they are really wreaking havoc. Boko Haram has been on ground for some time now. And of course, people from the northern part of Nigeria. By the way, Ilorin Diocese is in Kwara State. Kwara State is in southern part of Nigeria. So people who were driven from their source of livelihood, they were like driven from their place of residence and sojourn in the north. They came down to the western part. A lot of them are part of the church. They come to church. These are not lazy people, but they need to start afresh again. They have children. Yeah, the church has been helping, taking up their children, giving them education. And of course, because those children were born in the north, not all of them are really ready to like go through the normal rigor of academic work. And therefore, what the Catholic Church of Ilorin Diocese is trying to start is something like a vocational center. And we are doing this in collaboration with the members of St. Vincent de Paul. And so the vocational center is named St. Vincent de Paul Vocational Center. It is meant to train not only the children, but also even elders who don't have source of livelihood in some basic training so that they could stand on their feet. Giving out money to these people, the church knows you can't continue to do that in all of our parishes. We can't continue because the money is not even there. So why not train these people in some skills, whether it is hairdressing, whether it is fashion designing, but we need sewing machines. We need equipment. Even though we have volunteers who want to train, we need a space where they will do that, and we need to equip the place. And that is what I'm here to talk to you about today, to preach about today as we preach the mission appeal for this year. So in the Ilorin Diocese, we will be very grateful if you can help us. If you can help us, we will be very grateful. And we hope that next year, when we are planning for the mission appeal, we could bring to you videos and some preachers, though that will be directed to the Pontifical Mission Office of the Hague Diocese, how we are making progress in all of this. So whatever you do today, know that you are touching the life of someone who has been displaced and is finding how to start a new life. A child whose parent does not really have a means of giving him a future or her a future, but you are assisting. So your donation is geared towards that. Whatsoever you do to the least of my brethren, that you do unto me. When I was hungry, you gave me to eat. When I was thirsty, you gave me to drink. Now enter into the home of your Father. I hope that at the end of our stay in this life, the charity we do will take us to heaven and enjoy the company of God forever. But before that, we need to know that as Jesus is ascending to heaven, he is not asking us to look up to heaven and forgetting about what we need to do while we are still alive. No, he's asking us to go out and show the compassion, the love in the world. May God bless your families. May God bless your prayers. May God grant you joy and peace, healing from heaven above, as you hear my word, the word from the Lord, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Shall we rise and profess our faith? I believe in one God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe one Lord, Jesus Christ,
who will be the Son of God,
born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate with the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
As students of God, with hope and confidence, we bring our prayers to the Lord.
For the church, that we may never lose sight of Jesus' final command to his disciples, go into the whole world and proclaim the gospel to every creature, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may work together to build the unity Jesus envisions, drawing all peoples together into a community that values justice, life, and peace, we pray.
Lord,
for all those who are initiated into the church this Easter season, that they may bear witness to Christ's influence in their lives by the way that they live, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the St. Vincent Vocational Training Center and for all those served through it, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our parish community may proclaim the good news in the way that we minister to those in need, we pray.
Lord,
for the special intentions in our parish, for those who are sick and homebound, especially Mary Baker, for those who have died, and for Father John Bauer, for whom this Holy Mass is being offered, we pray.
Lord, hear us.
Heavenly Father, guide us in bearing witness to you in the way that we treat each other, in the way that we treat the stranger, in the way that we treat all people. Hear the prayers we make and grant them through Christ our Lord.
Amen. As the gifts are being prepared, please join in singing from your blue gather book number 601, Seed Scattered and Sown. That's 601 in your blue gather book.
Shared by all the living.
pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty. Amen. We offer sacrifice now in supplication, O Lord, to honor the wondrous ascension of your Son. Grant, we pray, that through this most holy exchange, we too may rise up to the heavenly realms through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for the Lord Jesus, the King of glory, conqueror of sin and death, ascended today to the highest heaven as the angels gaze in wonder, mediator between God and man, judge of the world and Lord of hosts, ascended not to distance himself from our lowly state, but that we, his members, may be confident of following where he, our head and founder, has gone before. Therefore, we overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exult in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take these, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Bernard, our Bishop, and all the clergy. We pray for Father John, for God's blessings upon him. Remember also our brothers and sisters who are falling asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Jesus, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Jesus, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Jesus, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us your peace.
Brethren, behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that I should enter under my roof, but only through the word of my soul. May the body and the blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Amen.
as we approach God's table, please join in singing from your red worship book, number 530, A Hymn of Glory, Let Us Sing. That's 530 in your red worship book.
Glory, let us sing. New songs throughout the world shall ring. Alleluia, alleluia. Christ by a road before untrod ascends unto the throne of God. Alleluia. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. The Holy Apostolic Band upon the Mount of Olives stand. Alleluia, alleluia. And with his faithful followers see their Lord ascend in majesty. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Alleluia. To whom the shining angels cry, why stand and gaze upon the sky? Alleluia, alleluia. And with his faithful followers say, this is his glorious triumph day. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Ascending high up to the portals of the sky. Alleluia, alleluia. Hereafter, Jesus, you shall see, returning in great majesty. Alleluia. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. O Lord, our homeward pathway bend, that our unwearied hearts ascend. Alleluia, alleluia. We're seated on your Father's throne. You reign as King of Kings alone. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia.
for the benefit of our brothers and sisters who may be joining us online, we shall have the spiritual communion prayer now. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who allowed those on earth to celebrate divine mysteries, grant, we pray, that Christian hope may draw us onward to where our nature is united with you, through Christ our Lord. We have a couple of announcements. Next Saturday, May 22nd, at 11 a.m., there will be another survey training for all interested students from grades 4 to 12. We also welcome our current servers who would like a refresher training. Please let the parish office know if you are interested. Don't forget to RSVP if you plan to attend the Immaculate Mary's Church 75th anniversary celebration dinner, which will be coming up on June 12th following the 4:30 p.m. Mass. You can RSVP in the garden space by putting a token in the box for each member of your family that plan to attend. Kids from grades 1 to 12, get your registration in for
Totus 2 week this summer from July 19th to 23rd. Registration forms can be found on the welcome desk, online, or in the parish office. You can also mark your calendar for all parish potluck on July 21st. All are welcome. And on behalf of my diocese, once again, I want to appreciate the Archbishop Bernard and also the pastor, Father John, and all of you for having us come around this morning to make mission appeal in this church. We continue to keep you in our prayers, just as we request, and indeed, I mean it, we request your prayers for my diocese, Ilorin Diocese in Nigeria. May God bless your week. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go forth, the Mass is ended.
As we ready ourselves to go, please join in singing from your red worship book number 526, Sing with All the Saints in Glory. That's 526 in your red worship book.
Life eternal, Him rejoices.